Hi, welcome to Prep Talk. I'm your host, Jay Seymour, and we're here to talk about 70-331, which is the first MCSE for SharePoint exam, Core Solutions for Microsoft SharePoint Server 2013. And I'm pleased to have Bill Baer, who's a product manager in the SharePoint group. Bill, thanks for being here.
Thank you, Jay. I'm Bill Baer. I'm a senior product marketing manager in our SharePoint product group. On a day-to-day basis, I focus on our IT professional audience and their particular needs around our product. I'm also a Microsoft Certified Solutions Master and have instructed the Microsoft Certified Solutions Master courses.
So, Bill, this exam kicks off the SharePoint MCSE with designing a topology. Why is that important to get right, and what skills are most critical in that?
You know, one of the most important aspects of SharePoint is really aligning yourself to the topologies that we recommend from a product perspective. Not only what it does for customers is allow them to maximize value for the purchase of the product, but it also allows them to maximize the value for their users and derive greater business mobility. What that basically means is choosing the right topology is one of the most important steps as you think about a SharePoint deployment. The right topology really enables that customer to maximize their investment in the product. It also enables you to ensure that the product meets the demands of the users, not only today, but also in the future.
And so those are important skills that we test on. Another thing that we do in the test is we really make a distinction between authentication and authorization. We ask a lot of questions about that. Can you explain the differences and why those concepts are important to a candidate?
Authentication is really the aspect of verifying the credentials for a connection attempt to a resource, whereas authorization is validating that that user is actually allowed to access that resource. And authentication always occurs prior to authorization. And those are two important aspects to understand. Most of your time is really going to be spent performing tasks related to authorization as opposed to tasks related to authentication.
So, you know, there's a whole section in this exam that's based on web applications and site collections. What are some of the gotchas that you think that a candidate should keep in mind when they're taking the test?
In respect to web applications versus site collections, and obviously there's a hierarchical aspect to those particular entities, but the most important thing that you need to understand about either object are really the capacity and constraints related to those. So overcapacity concerns are largely one of the predominant causes of downtime from a product perspective. If you don't think about where the software boundaries are related to the number of web applications that can be supported within a particular farm environment, or the number of site collections subsequently that can be supported underneath an individual web application.
So it seems like the end of this exam wraps up with topics like monitoring, tuning, and troubleshooting. These are often skills that it seems like people overlook. Why is it important to get that stuff right?
Well, let's take a step back all the way to the first question. As we think about it from a core product perspective, we think about authorization versus authentication. We think about site collections versus web applications and some of the important aspects about that. But one of the things that most people don't necessarily think about or plan for as an initial aspect of the deployment process is really how am I going to monitor authentication failures, authorization failures? If I do exceed capacity at the web application or site collection level, how am I going to understand those unique intricacies of the product? And that's where monitoring becomes so effective. You want to be proactive as opposed to reactive and potentially stop problems before they can even occur. A great monitoring plan means that you're proactively reviewing the information available to you to ensure that the product meets the necessary SLAs that have been defined by the business requirements.
And that's just the type of stuff that we're trying to test on here in this exam. So thanks for being here, Bill. I really appreciate you stopping by.
Yeah, Jay, thanks for having me here today in the studios.
So we've been talking about 70-331 Core Solutions of Microsoft SharePoint Server 2013. It's one of the exams in the MCSE for SharePoint. So go out, take that test.